Bit. Welcome to the Chopp Shot Radio!
Actually, it's off air still.
What's going on? So we're still recording though. Well, we still, but guess what? We're going to be doing the Facebook stream. Like I said, that gets us our most likes anyway, so let's just keep that moving.
Yo, new year, new money. Shout out to everybody fucking with us. You know what I'm saying? If you a hater, stay in your lane because we ain't got time
Do we got haters out there?
I don't know.
Probably do, but you know what I
don't
we
got to
do?
But they don't step up. 401-751-5600. Boys, yeah.
100.
Be freaking anonymous. Be like,
be proactive with your
Well, it can't be too anonymous because we're going to see the number.
If you ain't going to call and be up front with it, they're going to leave you last year. All anxiety. That shit, you know what I'm saying?
That's it.
Yeah.
Damn thing.
What's today's date?
Today is
Fizif.
Yeah, I was
gonna
say the 6th.
No, I know because I just paid my rent today. You know what I'm saying? Like 30 more days in the game.
Restart, nigga.
Restart.
The world is mine, nigga.
Radio, new year.
Welcome.
We here. You know what I'm saying? We here once again in your face.
In your face.
In the music fiend place.
You know.
Radio.
81 Richmond Street
is the space. So feel free to call us 751-5600-401's
area code. Let's not give him the address in case what he is when to come shoot this shit up. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, I already made that public. It's okay.
If
it's all good.
If anybody that feels any kind of way, feel free. No ID. You see?
Oh, we might have our first hater. Look at this. Hold up. They don't even put the number. Look at this. Hello.
Chopp Shop. What up? Who this?
This is Brandon.
What up, Brandon?
Are you a hater?
What's going on, bro?
What's up?
Brandon, do you hate or love us?
Oh, I love you guys. I love you guys.
So where you from, Brandon?
What's up?
Where you from?
I'm from Westminster, Massachusetts. I'm on the Tech 9 team.
Oh!
Massachusetts calling in. Tech 9.
We didn't see a number, so we thought you were a mass hater. We thought you were going to call up like, kill Nobby.
This guy's my number because he thought I was going to talk a little bit smack about him.
Oh, is that how it goes? Okay.
Thought you was a masshole. What's up?
Thought you was a masshole. So what's going on, bro?
What's going on, bro?
You guys are nuts.
How's life? How's life treating you, man? What's poppin'? What's new for the new year?
Man. I mean nothing. I'm gearing up to go boarding right now. So.
Okay.
And what was your name again?
Nah, I'm just kidding. Brandon.
Brandon, I remember you from the list of people with the Tech 9 Riders. For everybody who doesn't know out there, we're talking to Brandon, who is one of the Tech 9 Riders. Tech 9 Snowboards has been around over 20 years. They are also our sponsor. They sponsor the Chopp Shop and the United, you know what I'm saying, Soul Alliance and the Universal Zoo Disciples. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so check my nigga shirts out. You see, you got the Tech 9 gear
right
here. Now.
We got Tech 9 in the building. We rocking that Tech 9.
I won mass Tech 9 snowboarding events.
Yep.
First place.
He did that 1080 one time.
I won that thing. So, hey, so real quick, while we got you on the phone, because we got to let you go soon, because we got another guest calling in, and we appreciate you calling in. But so what's it like to be a snowboard rider? You must have gotten a lot of injuries, right?
I've had so many injuries over the years too, but I'm nursing one right now.
Oh, so that's why you're not coming tonight with the rest of the guys.
I'm going snowboarding.
What happened? What happened? You did a backflip and you landed on the board and you hit your ankle? What happened?
Something like that.
That looks
easier than that, but.
So where the snow at? It's not here.
Hell no.
Oh, yeah, it's not down there. Well, right now, up in Mass, we got a pretty good amount. Vermont. Vermont's killing it right
okay.
now.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Go up to Vermont. Or Neshoba Valley over in Mass. They have a ton, and they're just redoing their parks. So if anyone likes doing tricks and stuff, head over there. That's going to be sick.
All right. So that.
Hopefully we can get you down in the studios next time, you know?
Yeah. Hopefully soon. Yeah, I have that tonight. But it's really cool. So if anybody else is out there and you know they run across me on the hills, just come say hi and let's take some trips together.
All right, brother. Thanks for calling in. We're going to let you go because we got a guest, but we appreciate one of the Tech 9 Riders from the East Coast team calling in to support the Chopp Shop. Thank you, brother.
Much love, yo.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah, shout out, you know what I'm saying? Tech Nine Snowboarding Team, we out here, you know what I'm saying?
Tech Nine! Hey, so I really thought, honestly though, I really thought, no, I thought it was going to be a hater because the number was blocked because he was like, dude.
This kid connect from Connecticut.
Damn, they be on a date.
Dude, get a hotel room with me.
So I would like to clear the air and shit, you know what I'm saying? We do what we do as a movement, a universal, collective, broad, like, movement that's universal with international players. In-states players, like, it's all around. So if you're not messing with us, I'm telling y'all now, don't be going on social media talking no crazy stuff. Call us.
Somebody
and now we got ball, we need our caller.
We need that. We need that one right there. That one's gonna fit down, yeah. Peace, what's good?
Chop Shop, what up?
Peace, what's going on?
Welcome to the Chop Shop Radio. Who we speaking to?
It's King E. What's going on? Peace. Salute.
What up, King? What up, King Edward?
Peace.
We were just going over this, King Edward. Is it proper to say King Edward 7th, or you're supposed to throw the "the" in there, even though it's not in there written?
See, King Edward the 7th is straight. That's straight.
Oh,
right,
see,
there.
I
that's
told what? You were supposed to say
okay,
the "the".
Okay, okay. Is that like 7th generation?
This guy over here.
Edward?
Yeah, what's the science behind that name is really what he's trying to ask.
Yeah, I mean, basically, you know, I take pride in the number 7, man. I think it's, you know, a representation of God, you know, and I'm coming through blowing the 7 trumpet, so.
Okay.
You know, it fits perfect.
That's what's up, man.
So let everybody know what you do and, like where you come from, man.
So, you know what I mean? I'm an MC, man. I come straight out of North Carolina, you know. I've been on PYN and room management for, you know, for about maybe 4 years now, you know, so it's been a while coming. You know, I had to put in a lot of work, man, and, you know, so, yeah, I just want to give a strong shout-out to Wu-Tang Management and, you know, PYN, Moot, you know, Rob Bay, Born Divine, man, the whole squad, you
That's
know.
That's the homie right there, Born Divine.
Everybody, man, it's a blessing.
Yeah, shout-out to Born Divine, you know what I'm saying, Wu Killer B, and also the Vice President of Protect Connect Records, real good brother.
Born Divine. How was your New Year's?
Yeah, it was good, man. You know, I spent it with my sons and everything, so that was a blessing within itself.
Yeah, that's what's up.
We didn't really get no snow, man, so, you know, I just basically just, you know, family, always family-oriented, man, so it was a good day.
Yeah, that's what's
so
up.
What you got planned for this year, coming up a brand new clean slate? That's what we trying to get into.
Right. Shit, man, I mean, just networking, you know, staying positive, man, and you know, getting to know everyone and, you know, making sure I solidify my position in the game of hip-hop, you know, so trying to let everybody know the Global Warning, the album is coming. You know, we got Global Warning 2 in the works right now.
Global Warning,
got a lot of great producers. Yeah, man.
You want to shout some of them producers out? You want to give some
Shout out to my producer, man, straight out of Rhode Island, my man Essence, you know.
All right.
Out in Sweden, my man Flynn Beats, you know, so... You know, myself, I got a couple of produced songs on there, too, as well, man. But, you know, basically there, man, got a lot of good features on there. Shout out to Timbo King, you know, Yolanda Simmons, you know, great vocalist, great singer, man. So, you know, really a lot of good talent on the, you know, I enjoy working with everyone, you know.
You produce as well, you said?
Yeah, I do some, well, yeah, I kind of create.
That's good though. That's good though. It's good when because there's you know, not to disrespect anybody's craft, but as somebody who deals in the craft and somebody who interviews so many people, it's cool that people rap, but it's also a lot better when you can bring something else because, you know, a lot of people can rap. You know what I'm saying?
Right. And like you know, so you know, plus I wanted my DJ, man, DJ Wiz. You know, he did a lot of production on the project as well.
Yeah, DJ Wiz is good people. He just dropped that. We're on the 8. Go get that. Go to datpiff.com, and all you got to do is tape in 18 Fists, and it'll come up. 18 Fists to Shaolin by DJ Wiz. He's a good dude, man.
Yeah, it's some heat on there, man. The whole project was hot.
Yeah, I did a live stream, a preview of it on my page. If you go look at it, I didn't do every track, but I went through. That Solomon Child song on there went hard, yo. Right, yo, heal up,
yeah.
Solomon.
Shout out to Solomon. Yeah. Yeah.
So, okay, let me ask you this question. So, to get some direction, how does a guy from North Carolina, you know what I'm saying, rapping, doing what he does, how does he go from being an artist that just raps to being somebody who is signed to Protect Connect Records and dealing with Protect Connect Records and Wu Management? How does that happen?
Well, like, you know, upon the relaunch, you know, a good friend of mine had, you know, just set my material in. I've always been cool with Herc, you know what I mean, for a minute, you know, so, you know, he hit me up one day on Thanksgiving and was like, yo, you like family that we ain't seen in a while. But from that point on, you know, I was plugged in with Mook. I went up to the Gatto's gym in the Bronx, did a performance, you know, and just been building with them all ever since, man. It's basically really, truly a family, man. Shout out to, you know, Tanya Mitchell Hornets, man, you know. That's Lamar's sister. She's like one of my first managers, you know. They kind of brought me in, so, you know, but yeah, I've been doing it for a minute, man. So, like, right when I was about to throw in the towel, that's when it popped off.
You know, it's all about you right now, you know what I'm saying? But who do you look forward to, like, working with in, like, you know what I'm saying, this upcoming year? Like, somebody you got, you know what I'm saying, production-wise, or either MC or singer, vocalist, anybody you, like, looking out for, like, you want to work with?
You know, like, so far as, like, violinists, you know, I'm using violinists, so I like to work with, like, violinists, you know, I want to kind of step out of the whole element, like, don't get me wrong, like, I respect everyone's craft, but I kind of want to do something a little bit
different.
What's
wrong with that?
The
game needs that.
That's how
it
is. And they got these hip-hop violinists out here, man. Snag one of them up, man. You got a hit on your hands.
Yeah, that's what's up.
That Lindsey Sterling chick, whatever, is dope.
Mm-hmm.
She's fire,
bro.
She's unbelievable, man.
Right. Yeah, take any of your favorite songs and turn it into a violin head. You know what I'm saying? Like, come, come. You know, like, I need to do that.
She put a Kanye song on a violin.
I think my daughter, she on the violin for Christmas. I think she's watching those videos.
What's the
might trade in for a makeup kit or something.
So what's going on? So after that, the hookup and this and now you're doing that. And like you said, a lot of people don't realize that, like, the Wu World, DJ Worldwide, DJ Coalition, Patek Connect Records, and Wu-Tang Management have all been recently relaunched. I don't think a lot of people realize that.
Mm.
Right. Yeah, man. So, you know, but I think it was good. I mean, Everybody's added something to it, and, you know, Luke is a brilliant man.
He
knows what he's doing, man, and Jimmy, you know, they're brilliant people, man, and Born Divine has just added more brilliance to the situation.
Shout out to Jimmy King.
Shout out to Jimmy King, man, and, you know, Holly Pellman, man, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's some good, dedicated, hardworking people right now, you know, looking out for the artists right now, man, so, you know.
Yeah, so agree.
Big time.
So what is on? So what are we looking look for coming up next with you? What's going on? What's on board?
Well, we got the Snowflakes right now on the 18th, you know, with DJ Riz, man. So in the first segment, you know, we got the joint I got with Snoop, Beautiful Ladies. You know, that's been ready to drop. You know,
you got a joint with Snoop about to drop?
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm
waiting on high.
I know, right?
Hey,
I
keep
the nuts
or something.
Nuts, that's major.
Yeah, Legendary Fritz is on there. Ooh, Legendary Fritz. I got Johnny Cool on it, singing the hook. You know, it's a nice track.
What's the name of that track?
It's called Beautiful Ladies.
Oh, that's cool.
Again, it's Snoop in the background with it.
And the visuals is going to be promising for that? Any visuals for that?
Yeah, we got the visuals on deck right now as we speak, man. So, you know, that's in the next day or so, you know, that's going to be out there. We're going to be blasting.
Oh, so y'all already dropping it like in a day or two or something?
See it?
Yo, when it's exciting, you know.
Oh, man.
Dark, you know what I mean? That's the B side. You know, that's another smoker, man, produced by DJ Wiz, you know?
That sounds
like
that name, Blowing the Dark. Blowing the Dark, yeah, I like that a lot. There's a lot of double meaning in that. I like that.
Word up.
Yeah, man.
So,
Okay. Yeah, I'm saying, we got the visuals for that too right now, you know, so I just look forward to it, man. I took my time with this, you know. A lot of times I was like trying to, you know, force the issue, and, you know, but sometimes, you know, time is a beautiful thing, man, you know, so everything is meant to happen in its own time and place, man. So now looking back, I'm glad that I'm coming to the forefront right now. I'm glad that my project is being released because, you know, a lot of things has changed since the beginning till now, you know? So
yes.
A lot of lessons and everything was learned in the whole process, man. So I'm grateful.
Yeah.
I'm grateful.
We were out in North Carolina early last year, And we got to see some of the local talent out there. We got to go through shows. What do you see, like, how do you feel about the local talent and the scene out in North Carolina?
Don't forget to shout out Cesar Camacho.
I mean, I'm saying it's a lot of undiscovered talent. Like, I always look at North Carolina as kind of like, you know what I mean, in reference to, like, the Middle East. You know what I'm saying? We're on the East Coast. We're right in the middle.
Yeah.
And for some reason, it's like, it's always been overlooked a little bit. You know, people, it goes from, like, VA to straight to Georgia, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, like, you know, I was like, you know, where we fit in that right now. So, you know, I'm just glad to represent North Carolina, you know, to let people know that, you know, not everything is really, you know, shout out to all the trap artists, but that's not the definition of
because when Cesar Comanche Ghost Dog came out here, it was like a breath of fresh air. These guys was kicking that craziness, and we're like, "Where you from?" Oh, yeah, no, yeah, that is hard body, you know, like yeah, that's, it was that's crazy.
Expected, we kind of like expected.
Yeah, Ghost Dog was on his like, yo. Going yeah. in.
Yeah. Shout out to Ghost Dog, shout out to Phantom Blaze, shout out to Samson.
Yeah, everybody knew man, no kind of
the
Panther. Awesome.
And the OG Cesar Camacho came out to go to see us rock.
Mm-hmm. Silhouette, yeah.
Yeah, Silhouette, shout out to
Silhouette. Yeah, it was quite different from what we expected.
We ended up in Greensboro and the Shiners, right?
Yeah.
and then we ended up in the Deep South.
The Deep South ball, yeah, that's probably it.
Yeah, and Raleigh.
Raleigh, yeah.
So that was
a good time. We
all from up north, so it was kind of like a different scene. Mm-hmm. It was very awesome to see everybody, like, you know, being there, supporting everybody to the end.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
you don't see that over here. Everybody, when they do their set,
yeah,
they out of here. They're gone. You know?
Yeah.
Over there, they were sticking to the end. After it all, there was all chopping with us, so it was just a whole different vibe. Like, okay, like, that's what's up. They take more pride in, you know what I'm saying, the material and stuff that they put out there. So
yeah, for sure.
That's what's up.
Yeah. Like, you know, I spent some time. I grew up in Flushing, you know, in Queens a little bit. You know?
Okay.
You know, yeah, man. So, I stick with Queens quite often. But I love North Carolina, man. I mean, you know, it's got its pros and its cons.
Yeah.
But it's quite peaceful, man. It's a lot of acreage, a lot of greenery out there that you're just thinking, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like there was a lot of New Yorkers, like, well, not a lot, but there was quite a few New Yorkers up in North Carolina.
Yeah.
But I think that people like to migrate from New York to, like, North Carolina and to South.
Yeah, man. So, well, I mean...
Did you hear the question that he asked? Why do you think that people like to migrate from up north to down south, like to North Carolina?
Like, from New York specifically.
I mean, if I could come over here, I'd say the solitude, you know?
Yeah, to get away from being, like, constantly surrounded by something.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, it's kind of just moving and everything is just moving and moving. And sometimes, you know, we just want to just relax and get the concept of life, you know?
Yeah.
Really about, because people are moving so fast when they don't have time to actually stop and think.
Exactly.
You know, about the true meaning of life, man. It's the hustle and bustle. Mm-hmm. You can be overwhelming sometimes.
Yeah.
You know?
And not only that, but, you know, it's the little things. I remember I was in High Point one time when my grandmother passed. And I'm out there hanging out, I looked over to the side, and I seen a lightning bug. I ain't seen one of those things. I was like 5-6 years old. I feel like a kid again, man. Drove me crazy for a second. Changed my whole outlook.
The real thing.
Yeah, man. That's what's up, man. I'm going to take them to visit out there soon, man. Real talk.
Yeah, what's up? Man. I love it out here.
So where's, like, your inspirations, like, right now? We'll get you going and want to make music and keep going with that.
My daughter, man, you know, like, she does this thing where, see, I don't listen to my music that much, you know,
yeah,
but
same way.
She has this thing where she just runs around the house just like bobbing her head, right, like on some rock and roll headbanger with her hair blown out, you know, and she's trying to beatbox, and I'll be like, you know, thinking to myself, man, I need to, you know, that's inspiration right there. Listen, man, when people come up to me and be like, yo, man, you don't know, like, you got lyrics, you know, and I'd be like, you sure don't go over people. They're like, nah, you seem very good at your pronunciation and, like, stuff like that. The people kind of motivate me.
Yeah.
Like, music-wise, I kind of, you know, I'm not stuck in the 90s, but I just like creativity.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, exactly.
I really like creativity, so I listen to, like, classical music to Red Man Red the album, you know, like, I refresh what made me feel this way to begin with, you know.
No doubt.
So, and people wanted to look up your music and find it, how exactly, what would be the best way to route to find any of your stuff that we're currently?
The key word with the 7th Hip Hop.
All right.
Slash Wu-Tang, you know, SoundCloud.com, man.
Because you know what I'm saying? Because I don't want it coming. I don't want them to try to look for your stuff and then find stuff on the historical figure King. That's why I wanted to make sure you say something so that people that are interested, because the people that are tuning in on the Facebook stream or the stream that we have up and running on the regular stream or watch the archive or whatever, I just want to make sure they can locate your stuff.
Mm-hmm. So I usually ask this question, BXMGs, you know what I'm saying? What's your top five like MCs? Or it could be like nobody that passed away, can't be no legends, but top five in your list right now.
All right, cool. That's I'm gonna say Jizzle.
Okay. Yeah, Jizzle. Yeah.
Cannabis.
Yeah. Even though he pulled out a notepad on his battle, come on, man.
So, Cass, did you want to ask the next question? This is a part of it. This is special. We're about to take you into a very special part of the show.
So, you know what Bourbon Street is known for? You know the name besides Mardi Gras?
This never gets old.
Yeah. I'm familiar.
Yeah, you know what it's known for besides, like, Mardi Gras itself?
Nah, put me on to it.
In Rhode Island, we call them, in New England, we call them bars.
Bars.
So that means this is the portion of the show where you gotta give the audience something, because we're talking all about hip-hop, so you gotta show them what it is.
Where's the bars at? Where's the bars, kid? That's Rhode Island lingo, you know what I mean?
Yeah, what the fuck they talking about, bro?
Who's that, yo?
Hey, in other words, we want you to rap a little bit.
Yo. He's one of the last dudes that got off to a false start. He moves slow like imitation spinners from Walmart. He's rocking fake chains and artificial tens. Stuck in McKinney and rocking artificial lens. Car, camouflage, gear for the year. I go back like Thundercats and soggy Applejacks. Twisting snap attacks. I'm hard to jack like an H2 on four flats. Jam like a hand-me-down Mac throughout your rabbit-ass mind, thinking of blowing on some hand-me-down track.
Don't hurt nobody.
Nice. Shout out to King Edward the
South. Yeah, man, like that, man.
Down the South, they may call it R's. We call it Baz. We don't use the R's up
here. Yeah, the R's are silent up here.
It's like it's spelled B-A-Z-Z-Z.
Baz. And shout the Lionel for the Thundercats, man.
That was that nigga right there. Sharp
as a ball
swords, yeah.
All right, brother. So, before we let you go, thank you for calling in.
Give out your handles, everything. You know, you can't give out your handles, like, where people can find you, like, you know, you're on your social media.
Yo, check me out at facebook.com/ you know, KingLevel101. You know, soundcloud.com/ KingLevel7. Newworld.com. Shout out to Navi Wilkinson. You know, the whole UK management, the Zoom bullies. You know, shout out to PYN. Global One is coming soon. And always, you know, they gotta know, man. Stay protected with that.
Always.
Alright, brother, thank you for calling in. We'll have to call in the future, and you and I will talk. We'll talk behind the scenes.
No doubt. God have a blessed day.
Peace, you too, brother.
Peace.
Lock. Alright.
Shout out to King Edward the Seventh. You already know. Shout out, baby.
Love.
Yeah. Hey, yo. Millionaire monkeys, microphone mix master. Make money from music, the fuck fifth faster. Slapper, bitch boy, knock the tooth out his grill. Sean Price beat the truth in the veil. Listen, if you knock on my door, I'm cocking the floor. Great escape from the law like a solid Shakur. From a time of crack, you can put your cock in the hole. Kind of worse when you're rocking on tour. Listen, groupie girls want to lick on your dick. Groupie guys want to get in the flick. I'm like, fuck you, give me some chips. Overall, they like Sean so ill. Who you think you is, Ron O'Neill? A lot of rock bar, par, scar, par on the grill. Big fucks, face cut, when they fuck with the real. Mighty slow, young, so dumb, guns is drawn. Calamity, all your family, your son is born. One.
I punch you in your face, nigga. Who the fuck you talking to?
Crush killer, destroy double savage, with catastrophe. It's dumb steel, nigga roaring, we smash through your adversary. Run the steel, can avoid it, the spasm, the agony, battered, you bitch bastard. We can call your old fat nigga.
Yo, Sean Price, boot camp best. Give me the number 2 pencil, watch me take the test. Shake your set, break your neck, competitors flee. Who the fuck rhyme better than me? Nobody, body, gut in my ear, OE in my palm. I'm Freddy Krueger, your face, Michael Myers, your mom. You bother with mine, that's when I'm sparking the numb. Pull out this thing, flame on like compliment time. Fantastic flow, connected concepts. Broke niggas with new kicks, that's my projects. My man like, fuck, you ain't reaching the kids. I stuck my hand out in 3 pieces wig. I'm doing my thing, you new to the game. Don't hate, celebrate, park, cool in the gang. I don't have a big crew, just rumors to ring. And a couple of loose screw dudes boosting your chain.
Fuck, you don't know me. I smack the shit out of you, bro. Fuck
off,
nigga. Fuck wrong with you, man.
Crush, killer, destroy, double savage, catastrophe. It's dumb steel, every roaring, we smash through the adversary. Run the steel, can avoid it, the spasmy, the agony. Can calm your whole faculty.
I knew it was pretty wild, man. I was in Canada.
It was pretty cool.
Canada! Yes.
We won't talk about who can't go there, but yes, I was Canada.
It was eventful. It was fun, man. It's, you know,
what they, part of Canada?
Ripping out Quebec.
Quebec.
They go man. They go fucking hard in Quebec.
You listen to Drake all day?
Nah,
no, they beyond that.
They were fans of that, man. It's all the first one in Canada, man. The first day I ran to was Bumble Wu Tang and shit. So I was like,
so you feel home, right?
It can't be that bad, you know?
Yeah. Hip hop's in the building.
Yeah,
man.
You know?
Yeah, man, what's been going on? What's new for Tech9 last time
you've
been here?
We've been doing, like, pretty much the same stuff. We got, like, a couple new riders. We have, like, a lot of, I mean, we got, like, basically the same squad and stuff. We still got Brandon Honeycutts on. I think he just called in and stuff. You know, we got Luma still on there. You got Joel on there.
And right now, we got
Mr. Yonas. Yeah,
Mr. Yonas, his brother.
We're talking about the Tech9 East Coast team right now. Now, basically, we have, like, now I'm running, like, the whole U.S. thing now. So, like, the whole U.S. team is pretty solid and stuff, and then, like, I mean, the whole East Coast thing kind of developed into, like, the whole U.S., so it's, like, pretty much
it's a universal
team. Yeah, we're doing, like, everything, and then we have, like, I mean, I run the U.S. side, but we have, like, we got riders, like, you know, all over the world. It's pretty crazy and stuff. We have a pretty deep team and stuff. We got dudes, like, in, you know, in England and shit. We got dudes, like, a ton of guys in Italy. Dudes in Canada are killing it. They're, like, hands down the filthiest. Yo, those
some real jams over there?
Oh, yeah. Those dudes are all, like, street dudes, just like going out and just going out and getting it.
Oh, man,
it.
I seen the video that you posted.
What's
the
street Canadians you hang out?
Huh?
What's the street Canadians?
I don't think...
They got some Jamaicans
over there.
Yeah, a lot of...
Jamaica
and all that. They got a lot of...
They throw mean snowball and shit.
We
all
Canada. We
got jokes.
Yeah, shout out to your man that was on the video of the Tech9 joint that he was doing all them stunts and all that with the hair and all that. He had the long hair.
Oh, Jack?
Yeah,
the brother? That dude's from Italy. That dude.
I was like, wow. He's like,
yeah, that dude's filthy. You see the one with they were doing on the castle?
I think so.
Yes,
I
was they were down in I think they were down in Australia. Like they took like a couple of guys from like DC, like roll with them and stuff.
Well, cool. It was like a day and night thing, so they showed a day and then they switched to the night, like in the same shot. The dudes doing the
same stunt, but on the day and night. Yeah, the dudes in Europe have been like they've been on a whole other tear and shit. And then like it's cool because like you know working with these dudes in different countries and different regions and stuff, and seeing everyone do the same thing and like you know just like really just like support everyone. It's been pretty dope. You know, it's been a cool run. But the dude you're talking about, he's filthy, man.
He's mentally every time you see him, he was there at the Real Jams, too. Then he did, like, a flip or something over there. Yeah, yeah. He's like,
Jesus wanted to make a real word for that. We did him.
He was thinking that. I remember it was a dude who's stage dived that day, too, right?
I was just telling the intern, shout out to the intern, what's up Simone?
Shout out.
I was just telling the intern how I thought I was a superstar at the whole thing, and I tried to stage dive, and nobody wanted to catch me, because I'm not a superstar.
You took a couple tries.
Well, I talked him out of it, though, because originally you wanted to jump off with a snowboard on, and I was like, I was like, you just going to break it.
We'd have been outside the Tech Nine circle of trust after we did that.
The Tech Nine, the lawyers and everything, nobody wanted to do all that, so we so I 86 the whole, me jumping off.
Yeah. So he put some free gear inside his shirt.
So what I had to do is I had to actually have him go get some Tech Nine gear, some sweaters like this one you see me rocking. Shout out to Tech Nine. You know what I'm saying? Or shirts like Cash and them got on, or G's got the jacket today, G's.
No, man, I was in a rush, yo. I can't even get the stuff that I've been through. So let's not get into that.
I had to take the Tech Nine gear and put it on my back and jump for them to catch me, and I had to put my t-shirts in my sweater, and I swear to God in my booty was wrapped a couple times, but I'm not complaining.
It was all due though, right? There was no girls catching you out there, man. Ain't no girl gonna be like, I catch this nigga and shit, you know. All I know is shout out to British Beer Company.
Yeah.
He knows what the fuck I'm talking about.
Sad joke.
So it was Beer Company's training. So anyways.
This guy.
So you got some events coming up like this month? Yeah, the next thing we're doing a block party. It's gonna be at Crotchet Mountain. That's I think on the 14th. Crotchet.
Crotchet?
Yeah.
What's that?
It's up in New Hampshire. Crotchet Rock. Close. It's close.
Sounds like an Atlanta somehow, somewhere.
Sounds like what?
No,
Crotchet.
Crotchet?
And what's happening at?
That's gonna be up in New Hampshire. It's like over by like, remember where the warehouse was? About like, maybe like half an hour from there. It's pretty dope.
Warehouse ain't different?
Nah.
It's gonna be a real
rest in peace.
They're gonna snowboard and say a block party. I don't think it's gonna be like on the
hat. I don't think we might have to like translate that. You know, I don't know if it's gonna be like.
Well, a bunch of snow. That is a block party.
Yeah.
That is the foyer.
It's not like the Dave Chappelle jump off. It's gonna be like, you know, it's but it's pretty dope. What we're gonna do is like, we get like a little rail jam thing going. It's almost like we did at UMass, but it just runs all night. You know, we get like a
performance thing. Hold up. Don't you guys.
We ain't doing it. I mean, you guys can always roll through.
No, but wait a minute. Don't you guys sponsor hip-hop groups?
Oh, we do.
Which groups are
we do? I believe we have your group.
Oh, my group?
I believe your group's on there. Yeah, that's true. And then, my dudes, we got...
USA?
USA, Red Rebel. Yeah, my brother and shit.
The OG, Napoleon from Wu City.
Shout out to Red Rebel. We had the stage on fire.
Red Rebel caught on fire at UMass. It's a true story.
Without even knowing.
He didn't want to tell nobody. He was like, I'm trying to hide his blood.
I'm glad.
I gave him a jacket like 10 minutes later. He needs another one because it caught on fire. That's all I know and shit, man.
There was a bunch of heaters on that motherfucking shirt. Yeah,
there was some heaters.
I got to put this in right next to
me. I wasn't saying nothing. I was next to the heater.
Oh, the cold motherfucker. So that, you know, that's what happened. And, you know, it's going to go down in history. So we had a wild night. It was a great night. And we loved Tech N9ne. It was a great
Yeah, it was wild. That was
great performances.
It was wild.
Great performances. Red Rebel's jacket caught on fire. Reality with stage diving. Yeah. I mean, it was my booty grab. Yeah. We have not determined. It was by men or women.
I think we actually determined that. We have determined that, but we'll leave it alone. You know what I'm saying?
Cigarette rolling contest. Remember?
What?
Remember they had that joint rolling contest?
Was that
in the same spot?
At the Ram Jam, nigga.
No.
Yes.
That happened at the Weed Lounge, like 2 years
ago. No. He went on the stage and he was like, don't say joint, say cigarette. No, he was like, here's a joint rolling contest.
No, he was like, guys that were representing some kind of
spot. Oh, yeah, that,
I don't know
Christmas party after Christmas.
Corporate, man. That's the corporate people. That's, you know, they do it after she dies. Probably.
So let me ask you this. Is it last year's Christmas or is it this year's Christmas?
Last year
it was in December.
So this is your Christmas party for next year.
Yeah, I had two Christmas
parties.
Yeah,
you know,
it's your year in advance.
They own one, I guess.
Hey, I get two Christmas parties this year on January because I got two different jobs. So, you know, it is what it is, you know?
Damn.
We need to have a Christmas party.
We do.
Tech N9ne, Universal Studios,
that's the same on that.
That is 2 weeks too late, man.
That Tech N9ne Christmas party, you did at the warehouse that time. That was lit. That was lit.
Your Christmas party last.
My birthday's on Christmas. Yeah. It can never be too late. I'll celebrate my birthday every day. Let's get it.
Did three Kings Day pass?
I get to pick them. Not yet. Y'all sure.
Yo, so after that event, what else is coming up?
I think the next thing we're doing is, what we've been getting into is, we're still going to do, like, the events. I think we'll still do UMass, do UNH, a couple other colleges. But what we've been doing is really getting everyone together and trying to do, like, a lot of film sessions and stuff. So if you guys want to get down with that, that'd be always dope and stuff. Yes. I think it's more so just...
Are we going to go?
Yeah. It's more so just, like, I think, like, the cool thing is, like, getting everyone together, you know? Whether it's, like, an event, we all just go and, like, rent a fucking condo and, like, loon or something and just rage for the weekend. It really is what it is and stuff. It's just like, you know, going out there having fun, you know. Yeah, so we won't do
she gonna put that sad face on the whole
thing. Oh yeah, you just gotta
guess who's not going.
Couch.
Sorry, we'll get you in there.
He's making all the moves.
Yo, I refuse to the couch.
We got board bags. We will fit you in a
room. I don't care what dumb house fits me. I refuse to sleep in the couch. I pick it up bed. I'm sleeping that shit. I'm cracking in the can. I'm working for breaking that shit. I'm sleeping right there. You don't have to hold me or nothing. I'll be on the other side.
I need a
Tech N9ne
bed.
One day, me and my baby mama at the time was my aunt. Well, she's still my baby mama, but she's my girl at the time. We was fighting or whatever, and I had one out the night before, and I just came home and went to sleep on the couch, and I'm sleeping. She's like, where you been at? I was like, I didn't go nowhere. She's like, I had to stand in my hand. I was like,
he had the wristlets and everything.
They gave me a slam in the emergency room. I was like, yeah, I was all fucked up. That's a tough one, man. I feel you on that.
So how does it feel when you're in your city, you know what I'm saying, doing your regular gig and they know you the Tech N9ne God, right? You know what I'm, that's what I'm saying in his regular dude.
I know
that somebody's in the house burning. They're like, ain't you Tech N9ne?
He's a muffin man. He makes muffins.
I can't cook. That's a fact, man. I feel that out. I can't even make fucking Pop Tarts, bro. I'm like,
you
see what you do, you know what I'm saying? On the other tip, other than, you know what I'm saying, your service to the community, do they see all the other stuff?
No, I mean, like, I kind of keep that, it's all, like, separate, you know, but, like, I mean, obviously, on that end of it, stuff.
Tech N9ne guy.
Yeah, a lot of things. a lot of dudes don't even know like I'm an EMT or any of that kind of stuff until they get broke off and I gotta like fix their shit, you know what I'm saying?
Snowboarding make you popular with the ladies like on a motorcycle?
Nah, I wouldn't be popular. What are you talking about?
So a lot of collaborations, I guess, are coming up, and a lot is coming up.
Yeah, I think the shit with my dude from Wu Syndicate, man, that's going to be pretty heavy
and
stuff.
Shout out to Napoleon, yeah, the older guard.
That's going to be, getting him out on that, that's going to be another.
Together.
Yeah, I saw that. They did like a...
Wu Syndicate is finally, if you know, Wu Syndicate were one of the few...
They never...
They said, well, allowed to rock the Wu-Tang name directly in their name, man. And they were from VA, there were three of them, Maya Lansky, Napoleon, and Joe Mafia.
Yeah.
And for whatever reasons, they haven't always been in communication with each other, working together the last couple of years, and I know Napoleon was incarcerated for a while, but now they're back, man. And like I said, Napoleon's a friend of mine, so shout out to Napoleon, but he's also on this team, you know what I'm saying? Good OG, and I'm glad the Wu Syndicate's back, man.
Yo, Wu Syndicate is that's legend. I remember
who's on that album was 12 O'Clock from Brooklyn Zoo, our big brother.
Yeah,
we interviewed him, what was that, last week?
Yeah, who'd you have on?
Yeah.
Did you have Rash Kaz on last week?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I saw that. I was like, shit, man. Hey, were they putting vodka in the bathtub?
No.
Because that'd be genius as shit, because those gummy bears, they expand, and like, you just be like...
That's just be jumping in there.
Just regular gummy bears?
Yeah, you never know, milk, cereal, they be doing crazy stuff. I be looking at them like, what are you watching?
Hey, bathtub full of spaghetti sounds good as fuck, man. I ain't gonna lie, man. There better be a lot of Parmesan in this motherfucker if it's a...
What's going on with the boards? New stuff coming out in Texas?
Yo, that's one of the heavy things is that we're looking to do some collabs and stuff. And I think one of the things that will be dope too is like, you know, we have the opportunity where we can like really branch all this stuff all together and have it to where it's, you know, if we have like boards where like we can get like different guys' logos on there, do some stuff. I'm totally down as fuck to have like a little Wu-Tang board or like, you know, get like some like, you know, do some stuff with you guys, get you guys' logo on there. I know Red Rebel, like, you know, doing some stuff with USA and stuff.
Yeah.
It'd be cool stuff. And anything that's like that, I think is like, is dope because, yeah, it brings in like, you know, you guys have your audience, we have ours and stuff, and it kind of just like merges those together and stuff. And it just, I think it's
crossbreeds.
Yeah, it's not crossbreeds, bro.
Yeah. It's crossbreeds.
Stop with it. Stop.
Is your breed our breed? Hybrid?
Hybrid is like, you never seen fucking a movie with the fucking Lycans and all that shit?
Yeah.
That's a walking hybrid. You know what I'm saying, right? You
trust me.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
Red Rebel in the building?
Red Rebel?
Oh my god. SH in the building.
Red Rebel,
what's poppin'? Welcome.
Another representative that is sponsored by Tech Night Snowboards.
Yep, USA, shout out to USA.
Into the light.
Shout out to USA, there I am.
What's up, bro?
Chill, man.
We
here.
So, Ray, could you introduce yourself to the people? Because you just came in, so you came in like a superstar. So, now you introduce yourself.
Red Rebel, United Soul Alliance.
Yep. He also sponsored by who?
Tech Nine.
And he's also really cool. So what's going on? So you are. We were talking about there was a story that was being told about you being one of the hip hop groups at a rail jam.
Oh, yeah. You had shit on fire.
And you was rapping so hard that your jacket lit up.
That happened. That happened.
That's a fact.
Yeah. Before you stayed there.
Before I stayed there. We were talking about the stage. I'm saying no one wanted to catch me, but then I had to put the gear behind my back.
Yep.
It was a wild night, man.
Yeah. Shout out to your future young MCs.
Yeah.
Z Rebel. Say hi to the people. They watching. Yeah. They all watching.
30
Z Rebel or who?
Do we agree up? Was it?
What's your rap name?
E Doggy Dog was the one we
agreed.
I helped him come up with that.
Yeah, he was at the warehouse. He told me what his name was.
Yeah, E Doggy Dog. We worked on it. Yeah. I said it like a joke, but he wouldn't let it go.
He ran with it. It's a rap name.
Yeah.
That's what's gonna make them.
I was trying to get him to go. I said E-Doggy Dog, and he was just with it.
Homeboy's list and Lyricist list.
That was a good list.
Yeah, I'm going.
King Ewitt?
Yeah.
That was dope. Maybe Ghost. So who would have been the other person? Because he said maybe Ghost. If you should put him in the five.
Well, they ain't big five. They ain't got nobody else to go with. Yeah. I mean, he ain't big like big six until that baby goes to honorary mention.
Yeah, you're right.
So what's good? What's new for the USA?
Man, a few albums coming out, actually.
Yeah, he's had a few albums.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, them artworks be dope, though, man.
Thank you,
man.
The United Soul Alliance is a group based here in Rhode Island, but they have ties all across the globe.
Yes, sir.
They do a lot of big things. They're my brothers in arms because they are, you know what I'm saying? We're a fan with them just because we're on the same mission, but also they're also sponsored by Tech Nine. And, you know, we invited Infinite to be here, but he was with the kids. And
Yeah. His grandmother passed today, too. So.
Ghost, man, is a guy who could take one letter and do a whole rap about
it. Oh,
he's
man.
Infinite is just a poet first.
Infinite does a whole hip-hop project with kids in inner city in Boston around Shakespeare.
Shakespeare and hip-hop is dope.
Which is pretty dope.
Shout out to Phoenix, a Mask Ferry event.
Yeah, man. Pete Money.
It's crazy how
all made by himself.
The 11th of February. It's in Dover. That's the next show coming up. We just did a show with Jimmy's.
Jimmy's alone?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, caller, who is this?
Hey, answer the phone.
Press the big phone. Chop Radio, who this?
This is Brentley.
Brentley?
I just want you guys to all know that Homer absolutely loves Coldplay.
I know that's a lie. Nobody likes Coldplay.
Brentley just got some shit.
Saying that is extreme though. Coldplay is fucking.
What
is wrong, man?
Engaged in warfare, then.
Messed up.
It is on.
Shout out to my people who checked in.
Yeah, that's the hybrid between the
I just feel like you can't say puzzle because it implies some type of injection. You know what I'm saying? So, what's going on for you guys? You guys are driving.
Like, yeah, man.
Consistent. One thing I can say about United Soul Alliance is that you guys consistently drop projects. You guys have a lot of projects under your belt, but you don't overdo it. Like, some of you
week and inflect it.
What I'm saying is that you guys have a good track record with coming out with stuff. And
you've
been doing it because there's a few of you guys, so I've done some that did the album that you gave me, that bang, the barcode.
Oh, yeah.
All this shit was dope.
Yeah, man, so appreciate
it. So, would be like, someone, you know what I'm saying?
No, the logo is serious. The Lions Den Yogo, that logo is fire.
Yeah, we have some crazy stuff coming, too.
What are the next couple of projects that we can expect from United Soul Alliance and your
We got this one called Monkey Kings. It's fully produced by Tiger Moth. He's from Australia. He's really
That's
dope.
That's the guy you're talking about, the producer guy from Australia.
Yeah, man, he's dope. We did a few cuts on a couple of our albums.
Yeah.
But
there's not like kangaroo noises on there.
Nah, nothing weird like that.
He's
dope. He worked with DJ Crush and stuff, man. Dude is nice. He toured with DJ Crush actually.
Dope.
Yeah, he's dope.
So that's
Monkey Kings, and then we got another fully album. This dude Zedesi, another European dude, did a whole project with him. It's called A Week. A Week in the USA.
Yo, that's what's up.
And it's fully produced by him. We did like a concept. Like every track is like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and so that's gonna be dope.
Yeah.
And we did both of those are done, and then I got an album called Three the Hard Way. It's this dude Sinister who's in United Soul Alliance from Staten Island.
Sinister, he does a lot of battle rapping.
Yeah, he's dope. Sinister, and then Sant, another dude from he's from the Bronx, but he lives in Newark now. The three of us did an album and it's fire, man.
So people wanted to find something on the United Soul Alliance and want to look you guys up, what would be the best ways to?
We're on Tidal, Spotify, we got a Bandcamp, Dark Stars Records with a Z. YouTube.
Big family, right?
Yeah, man.
You know what? You ain't need it. Wait. You got on the Chop Shop.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Trying to collab with all you guys too, man. We're trying to make it happen this year, man.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we can get you on the verse right after this.
I'm down.
You got the setup.
So that's what's coming up for the future for you guys.
Yeah, we got like three albums coming out right now.
Dope.
Like,
that's what I'm saying. Consistently putting the work, and that's really what it takes. So we were talking earlier. So somebody who's a fellow artist and a fellow person that's sponsored by Technine. What do you see? What do you think about the connection? Because Homer gave his piece, but what do you think about the whole connection between like the snowboarding company and then like what we do with him? Yeah.
It's dope.
How do you think about the fusion of the two? The hybrid of the two.
I think it's like next level, man. Like when Wu-Tang, I remember the Jizzle did that video, Crash the Crew with all the skateboarders and stuff. I see it as the same wave. You know, skateboarding, snowboarding.
That partnership with that skateboarding company out of Connecticut.
Oh, yeah.
The line of Killer B boards, and they did
Oh yeah, hell yeah, man.
We did two lines actually.
I see it the same way, man. Just, you know, fusion of, you know what I mean? It's an art. It's another art, you know?
Can you actually snowboard? Because I'm not that great.
No, I think I snowboard with him twice.
I was.
He
was in bad shape, though, but his defense.
Yeah.
There
was.
I would try it.
Snowboard is harder than skiing.
Of course, I bet. Because you on that one board and it's going to get going. You either got to fall back.
It's really harder than that, man. A lot harder.
Yeah, man, I'm scared to fall in the snow.
It's
so cold, it
hurts.
You just gotta just take
it. Nah, but with the Tech 9, just shoot, you're gonna be good. Shoot, because you gotta get the pants. What's the website?
I got onesies, man. It's just Tech 9
Snow.
I got onesies, I'm gonna get all you guys.
All right, you heard that?
So basically, you're just saying that the fusion between the two, you see it as something that is
natural.
Something natural.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not forced, but not everybody associates. Nah.
Well, like me and this dude go back, you know what I mean? We he's the original member of the crew. It's like me and him. Yeah. So I mean, when I came up with that name, it was like me working with him on hip hop wise. But I mean,
oh,
lot.
I mean, yeah. That's going way back.
So what is the 2017 besides the projects? Like, what is the direction? Like, what's going on with you guys? You're in Solo Lions. Like, what can we expect from you other than just the projects? Like, what is going on with you guys?
I mean, we're trying to do more shows, like, different states, you know what I mean? We're trying to get more money for stuff too, first of all, because I mean, like,
nobody wants to pay.
Yeah, and I think people are too happy. Especially locally, people are like paying to play shows, and it's like ridiculous.
Okay, they're getting paid.
It's backwards. At the end of the day, it's really, at the end of the day, though, some people are not in hip-hop for the love of it and for the dollar. But then people want to make you go through these, you know, all this other stuff. But the scene here is really messed up, and Rhode Island anyways. It's backwards. It's been paid to play. For a long time. A couple of people tried to get out of that box with the Fat Squirrel, but then something shot back. Yo, that was a good spot. Shout out to Alchemy next door, because they said no artist will ever pay to play.
That's good, man.
They made that statement. The owner of Alchemy, you know what I'm saying, which is next door towards here at the Chop Shop, he said straight up, he was like, yo, no one will ever have to pay to play here, which is interesting because then he put up a post where somebody was trying to hit up an artist and tell them to sell tickets to pay at Alchemy, but the dude they hit up was a guy who has a band, but he also happens to be one of the co-owners or a co-worker of Alchemy. And they, somebody else was trying to make him, you know what I mean, it's kind of confusing, but basically someone was trying to get over.
Trying to get in the middle and get some money.
That's what it is. He's the guy over there at Alchemy. So Alchemy is, you know, they had the Culture Games too. Matter of fact, you know what I'm saying, two-time winner. February 25th, part three. I'm going for my third win, freestyle champ.
Come out
of the Culture Games. Right now I'm saying it. Win or lose after this third time, I'm saying it now, so don't
retire.
Win or lose, I'm retiring from that specific battle because I want to give other people a chance.
That's the way
I'm gonna be a judge moving forward for the culture. Shout out to Dirty Dirty putting it together. I'm gonna be a judge on that going forward, and I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, judge. Yeah, why don't you judge? I'm gonna judge. Okay, I'm too old. I think that's what we should do. I'm gonna be a judge on that going forward, and I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, judge. Yeah, why don't you judge? I'm gonna be a judge. Okay, I'm too old. I think that's what we should do. I'm gonna be a judge on that going forward, and I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, judge. Yeah, why don't you judge? I'm gonna be a judge on that going forward, and I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, judge. Yeah, why don't you judge? I'm gonna be a judge on that going forward, and I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, judge. Yeah, why don't you judge? I'm gonna be a judge on that going forward, and I'm not gonna, you know what I'm saying, judge. Y
footsie pajamas, but maybe like
a footsie. Footsies though, man. You just like socks or something.
Okay. Yeah. 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 World, they got them all for you, man.
Yeah. Yo, you guys gonna rap?
Not today. We heard you today. We heard you.
Oh, you guys are all.
You can get around. You got a couple things you want to say?
No.
Live on.
No, there are millions of people. Now, there's probably like five watching this. There are millions of people watching right now, and they want to know, what does E Doggy Dog have to say to the world? No pressure.
Oh. He's like, nope.
But it's live. We can't fix it. No pressure.
I can fix it.
Oh, you. They huddle.
You can't.
It's on the Facebook screen. Do you know when the Daddy claps?
No.
No, come on, you guys do.
You like Daddy's music?
He does, yeah.
I know. You making beats too?
Sometimes, yeah.
These two were skateboarding in the warehouse.
Yeah. Oh, they was skateboarding. Remember that? They was on the skateboard, yo. Yeah. Especially her. They was hot
I don't fall back because I lost my skateboard. And they jacked my skateboard.
So, Red, that means you're going to have to go to Bourbon Street for the family, then.
No, all right.
Bourbon Street.
We're gonna ask you about Bourbon Street, right?
Yeah, I remember.
We go through this every time.
What happened last?
I had my daughter here. Now my bourbon street was real explicit. Now we're back looking at the video. I was like, why the hell did I do that?
He keeps the G, man.
Oh yeah, he do. You already know.
No beat or nothing. Sniffing Oxycontin, blue boxes hot, and throwing my tape, hip hop, Johnny Rotten, obscenity spin. Optical incision, kill my enemies, vision. Still drop more hot shit than a tropical pigeon. Belligerent rhyme contingent, force feeding heathens, more than the story eating. Forfeit your nose bleeding, 33 RPMs, my revolver repeating. Darth Vader death grip on your esophagus, no stopping this. Hip hop to skip the apocalypse, words stimulate the erogenous zone. You sick fucking ostriches, eviscerate your taste, and fake pop is preposterous. Fraudulent misogynist with less spit than throat lozenges. At a time like Atari cartridges. Blow Joe smoke for street pharmacists. At a time like Atari cartridges. Grow Joe smoke for street pharmacists. Four alarm blaze the arsonist bomb shit. The Teflon's on my left arm. Now who's harming this?
Beast.
I'm about to cut to a video. I'm gonna cut.
Yeah. I told my nigga come and talk to me. I could bring you to New Haven quick. When niggas know a nigga that know a nigga, what up with knowing niggas, nigga, I don't know shit. They don't know shit. They drop jewels, but niggas ain't never made nothing. They all talk, but niggas ain't never paid nothing. And then they get in the booth, start feeling they self, start talking that shit like if they spray something. In the hood, why y'all niggas play the law scene? I'm straight dropping this water all chlorine. The girl's dirty, and I still keep the ball clean. The bills paid, my daughter fed your boy. With the club scene. Matter of fact, I ain't even social. I disappeared for a month and followed a cold front. Yeah, I told you that my hustle coastal. You can't make it if you stay low. I never let a washed up nigga coach. It's a lot of that around here. So living, I crack a bottle and pour a beer. Whole dog here, no service or poor beer. Stand full of niggas and team, so yeah, we all here. Rather have them with a beam, let's make it all clear. Bang, bang, rush my gang, nigga, it's our year.
Straight like that. I've been a man since I started laying tracks. Ain't never been a time that I was whack. Always snapping off and dumbing when I rap. Never slacking when it comes to spitting facts. Bitch, you artificial, my artificial, you get it, my nigga, cause I be still in the track. Bitch, you artificial, my artificial, you get it, my nigga, cause I be still in the track. Bones, blunts, joints, and marijuana got me buzzing in the struggle to relax. Take another listen, my nigga, and run it back. 100 bars a minute is going over your cap. Flow is so offended, my nigga, riddle me that. It ain't about me if it ain't about scratch. I'ma stack it, put the state up on my back. Never slacking, macking, it's still attacking, so immaculate. Wasn't really battling, I told him like a javelin, overthrowing the savage. I ain't having it. Born a leader, never fought him, not the hacktivist. That's why I move like an activist. On the low, high, lean, no activist. Cause it seemed like a catalyst. Cause I'm a generation down and it's a sad shit. And I ain't hating, but I had a vent. Tell me what your life's like and use common sense.
Chopp Radio, we back in the building where Rebel Tech 9, man, Cobra in the building.
Cobra.
James, you already know. We out here, man. New year, new money.
Who's beer is this?
Not yours. It's not your beer.
So what's up, man? What's going on in the world? So, did you guys see that video that those guys did, the Harambe video, the end of 2016? They were like, Harambe, Harambe, Harambe. Harambe.
It's a Harambe. Yeah, she didn't do well.
Harambe. But they were talking about, not in that video, they were talking about all the people that, because a lot of, so many people have passed away in the last year. So now we're going into the new year, and, you know, there's a lot of energy around so many people passing away, so many, you know, so many babies being born, just like, you know, it's always happening, but it just feels like there's a lot of energy in the air for this new year, and I just wish everybody out there, regardless if you're rolling with us or not, whether we know you or not, whether you like us or not, if you're making moves and you're trying to build up something positive and trying to motivate the people that are around you and the people that you rock with, then we salute you.
whether it's from a distance or up close. We salute you, and we hope the year 2017 is a progressive year. If you're somebody who pretends to be like us, but you're not, and you're just fraudulent, then it'll all get exposed in 2017 anyways, so we'll all know what everything is by the end of this year anyways. So we coming.
We good.
We coming. So, you know, that's what it is, and that's what it's going to be. You know what I mean? We got Tech N9ne in the building, you know what I'm saying? We got the future MCs in the building. Over there, we got E-Doggy-Dog. E-Doggy-Dog, you was just, when the camera went off, you was just ripping the bars. What happened?
E-Doggy-Dog.
That's my boy. We came with that name together. It took us a long time. We did a lot of work to come up with that name. We went through like 20 minutes before we went for that. Yeah, and I said that one as a joke, and he wouldn't let it go. I was like, no. We should go with E-Rebel. He was like, nah. He's got to be the other name.
I said, that's my E-Doggy-Dog.
Yeah, no, he was with it.
He got to make his own language.
Yeah, I liked it. That's all I like. I liked it. It was dope. You know what I'm saying? And we got the, you know, we got the bars. So, Cobra, are you going to rap?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to rap?
Fuck, man.
Yeah. Man, get over here.
Like right now.
Yeah, right now. Yeah. What's up? No matter what it is.
Cobra.
Good or bad, ugly, beautiful.
Let's see.
We love it all.
Let's see it. Give me the seat.
Hey, bro. Can you spit something real quick? Cobra, where you from?
From Massachusetts, moved to fucking New Hampshire. Fucking been rotting there ever since.
Yeah. Didn't sound too happy about it.
It's
better case, it's not a lot. You didn't sound too happy about it. Alright, cool. So let's get some vibes from you, brother.
Alright, fuck it. Now I'm trying to sound cocky, but I'm sitting here with Navi, ready to rock. You can get in my way, but you can't stop me. Yeah.
Shit.
You got this. I got it. It's like 10 years ago, man. I can't fuck around.
You're tired.
Hey, you gotta give him credit for trying, man.
Hey.
Everybody, you show more.
Everybody, yeah, man, what's up? You gonna
spit?
You gonna rock?
Yeah, I don't want to do it to him like that.
The camera's off. There's really nobody watching. You can really rock right now.
He's lying.
You can rock right now. No pressure at all, bro.
Not really.
No? Okay. We got you next time.
Next time?
You get ready to drop that mixtape.
No.
E-Doggy Dog Presents.
She's on my album. He's not on it.
Oh, you're on the album rapping?
No, she's saying,
it's cool. Red Rebel. Oh, she's
That's what's up. They keep them involved, you know? They don't have the future to look back and be like, oh, damn, daddy had me going on the back, you know? That's pretty dope.
That's how you gotta do it. That's how you gotta do it. Because the kids are the future, and if you don't invest in them, I mean, what do you have if you don't have that?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so, it's for them to be more outspoken, to see somebody.
Mama, like,